Yo. So then, just in case you couldn't get enough of those retro game sounds last time around, I have a bunch more of them now. And I also have better versions of the ones I previously had, at least in one case. You might remember from from the last video, I had the Temple of Time sound, and it sounded like it was like out of tune, the choir voices of the Temple of Time. So here's the old one that I had. Not only is it out of tune, the voices are all going E, which I think in the original they're kind of changing their voices a little bit. Here's now a much better version of the same sound, which is pretty much identical to the what you heard in the game. Sometimes says ah instead of e. Now let me wrap it up. Thank you for sitting through all of that. But yeah, that's the OG right there. And I'm gonna throw that other one in the digital garbage. Found the exact guitar sound from Gerudo Valley also, or is it Gerudo? Who cares? But you'll know this. A lot better if I could keep like the strumming going on the left hand while at the same time doing that, like. Then I'd be really good, but I'm not. And those sounds came from finding a Majora's Mask sound font. So I guess all those same ones were there, including the corrected Temple of Time thing, but maybe they were just lumped together with sounds from, an Ocarina of Time sound font. But this sound was also in there. You know what that is. You're gonna tell me you don't know what that is? That's the desert and fire level. Sitar. It's called a tambour sound from Super Mario 64. So, I don't know if you hear that in the Zelda game because I've never played Majora's Mask. So I have to. So maybe it's really in there, but I just think it was thrown in there with just a bunch of different Nintendo 64 sounds. But that's what that is. That's definitely what that is. And then you just have this sound from Donkey Kong Country. Funky's Flights. I don't know why I didn't demonstrate that last time because it was there. Maybe I couldn't find it. Final Fantasy fans, you should know what this is. Shinra's theme from FF7. And that beat is just so badass that I could probably just use it and just throw a whole bunch of awesome shit. I could probably make multiple songs using just that beat because it's so nasty. Same game, folks, this very specific sound. Mithril mines At least that's what I was just playing there, but it was used for other stuff in the game as well. Plenty of other stuff like this. It's the Coral Prison. It's a very depressing piece of music. I remember being just as depressed as the characters at that point. Well, maybe not that much, but it's just all this desert that just goes on for miles, and you're like, I just want to get back up to the surface, please. This is very depressing. And something as simple as this string sound right here. Although that's not the same key as the intro is of Final Fantasy VII, that's actually the same key as the piece of music when you're up in Bugenhagen's observatory. That's the key that it's in. It's the same, you know, melodic progression, but just in a different key. So that's that. And just to show you one thing from the Super Audio Cart, which is a big collection of retro game sounds that you can get for your recording software. It has sounds from Genesis, SNES, NES, Commodore, Game Boy, stuff like that. And a lot of the sounds, when you hear them, you say, yeah, I've definitely heard that before, I'm just not exactly sure where. But in the case of this sound, you know where you've heard it before. That's totally the same sound that was used for Wing Fortress Zone from Sonic the Hedgehog 2. I don't have any other specific examples, really, because I guess my ears aren't good enough to decipher where every sound in that library is from. But there's that, so just take it. And before I'm going to wrap it up here with the last game I'm going to talk about, the next to last game I'm going to talk about is made by the same people as the last game I'm going to talk about, Rareware, who made Banjo-Kazooie. I just recently found the sounds from Banjo-Kazooie, and I've never played the game before. So when I found a bunch of the sounds, I said, I don't know what I'm going to do with these, because I've never played the game before. I don't know how they are relevant to me. But then I found a couple of sounds that really stuck out to me. These ones. I don't know where in the game they are, but I've definitely heard them before. In a totally different game, made by a different company, on a different system. I'll show you right now. We'll just listen one more time. And now watch this. So those are definitely in Toshinden, in Foe's stage, Foe's theme song. But what I want to know is, where did they originally come from? Who made them? And how much other stuff are those sounds used in that I don't know about? Or are those the only two things out there where those sounds are used? Because I noticed that there's there are other sounds in Rareware games that I've heard in other places. For instance, the last game I'm going to talk about now is GoldenEye. And there's totally some sounds in GoldenEye that I've heard in other places. For instance, the sounds of the guards grunting, which for some reason I don't have them in the sound font, but you know, all the hoi, hoi, ha, all that stuff, those exact sounds are definitely all over the place. I've definitely heard them in a ton of different stuff. Those exact sounds, and anyone who's played GoldenEye just knows, they even know the sequence of when the sounds play and which one's coming next and whatever. So I think I'm definitely not the only one who's picked out those sounds in other media before. But here's some other stuff in GoldenEye that I've heard in other places. This sound from the jungle stage. I've heard it in another video game for sure. This game. Now, it's in a different pitch there, but wait a sec. Here's the original sound. Now, okay, stop looping. I didn't ask you to loop. Nobody told you to loop. Nobody told you to do anything. And if I go to pitch shifter, right about here? Let's try that. 1.5 and negative 51 cents. More like it? I mean, that's probably one of those sounds that's used in a bunch of different stuff, too. And I just don't know it. But, yeah, probably it's probably used in a lot of movies, I would think. One would think. One would assume. This sound right here, you hear it in the theme of the control center in GoldenEye. That's why it's in the GoldenEye sound font. But that's definitely not the only place I've heard this sound. I associate this sound with the 90s for some reason. And here's the two places I've heard it.
If I'm gonna eat somebody, it might as well be you.
Uh-oh.
Can you dig it?
So can we find out?
And just some more cool stuff from GoldenEye to wrap it up. Egypt. Voices in the Egyptian level. This one. Frigate level? Frigate? I don't know how you pronounce that. I've never had to use that word in my normal life. But that's also the theme from Goldfinger, for anyone who might not know that. And I just want to close up with this thing. It's the guitar riffs from the intro of GoldenEye, the video game. You know, when they're showing all the different characters and there's a guitar player riffing around. They have the guitar riffs here in the sound font, but it's like split up between the different keys. So it's like all fragmented. So I had to kind of figure out where everything was. That took me a while to figure out. Don't think that was easy. I had to go, this one, then this one, then this one. It was like playing a game of Simon. But anyway, thank you for watching this whole damn thing. And if you like what you see, you want to see more stuff like this, let me know. Subscribe, like, whatever. I'm not one of those people who's going to say, please don't forget to pound that like button and pound it. Do what you want, all right? Do what you want. But I'm probably going to have more stuff like this. But in any case, I write a lot of music using all of these sounds. And as I said last time, I don't mix and match them. Like, I'll say, this song was made using sounds from this game. This song was made using sounds from that game. So it'll be like, you know, if you wanted to listen to songs from that soundtrack and you wanted to hear new stuff that sounds like it was from that soundtrack, I have that for you. So, that's it. Thanks. See you later.